And I am Teacher Anne, and today we'll be talking about meanings, forms, uses, and approaches of performance-based assessment.
At the end of the lesson, the students are expected to demonstrate an understanding of meaning and forms of performance-based assessment
and discuss the uses, focus, and approaches of performance-based assessment. What is performance-based assessment?
A performance-based assessment, according to Conception et al., is a straightforward and a systematic observation of students' individual results based on a prescribed performance criteria. A performance-based assessment, in general, assesses the student's capacity to contribute the expertise and experience gained from a module or a learning unit. The job typically requires the students to use a higher order thinking skills to produce a product or finish a test. Another thing, performance-based assessment requires the student executing a skills in a workplace, at a field of study, or simulated practical environment. Primarily, assessing the field of real-world experience, if you want to know if a student is capable of executing a skill effectively, the most reliable way to test the student's abilities is to observe to see whether they're knowledgeable or competent while performing their test.
What are the forms of performance-based assessment?
We have three forms of performance-based assessment. Number one is the standard response test. Activities for a single assessment may be multiple and varied. Activities may be extended over some time. Products from different students may be different in focus. The number two form of performance-based assessment is the restricted response test. In restricted response test, intended performances more narrowly defined than on the extended response test. Questions may begin with a multiple choice or start answers time back, then ask for an explanation or justification. May have introductory material like an interpretative exercise, but then ask for an explanation for the answer, not just an answer itself. The third form of performance-based assessment is the portfolio. Portfolio is a purposeful collection of a student's works that exhibits a student's efforts, progress, and achievements in one or more.
What are the uses of performance-based assessment?
Good question. We have three uses of performance-based assessment. First, assessing the complex cognitive outcomes such as analysis, synthesis, and evaluation. Second, assessing the non-writing performance and products. Number three, must carefully specify the learning outcomes and construct activities or tasks that call for it. Now, how you hear the focus of performance-based assessment? According to Gabuyo, 2011, performance-based assessment can assess the process, product, or both the process and the product, depending on the learning outcomes. It also involves the doing rather than knowing activity or task. The teacher will assess the effectiveness of the process or the procedures and the product used in carrying out the instruction. The question is, when to use the process and the product? Use the process when there is no product. Number two, the process orderly, a directive observable. Number three, product procedure steps are crucial to later success. Number four, analysis of procedural steps can be helped in improving the product. And number five, learning is at an early stage. On the other hand, use the product when first, when different procedures result in an equally a good product. Number two, procedures are not for observation. Number three, the procedure have been mastered already. And number four, products have qualities that can be identified and judged.
What are the different types of performance-based assessment approach?
Good question. In 2012, Gabuyo suggested four different types of performance-based assessment approach. The number one is checklist approach. Shuttle's approach is the observation instruments that divide performance whether it is certain or not specific. The feature has to indicate only whether or not certain elements are present in the performances. Number two is the narrative or anecdotal approach. In narrative or anecdotal approach, it is a continuous description of student behavior as it occurs, recorded without judgment or interpretation. The teacher will write narrative reports of what was done during each of the performances. From these reports, teachers can determine how well their students met their standards. The third approach of performance-based assessment is the rating scale approach. In rating scale approach, it is a checklist that allows the evaluator to record information on a scale, noting a more exceptional distribution such as presence or absence of behavior. The teacher indicates to what degree the standards were met. Usually, the teacher will use a numerical scale. Lastly, the last approach that was Gaboyo suggested is the memory approach. In memory approach, this is when the teacher observes the students when performing the task without taking any notes. They use the information from their memory to determine whether or not the students were successful.
For the insight, the overall goal of teaching is to allow the learner to apply what they've learned in a meaningful, practical application. Knowledge-based assessment measures how much of the contact information has been articulated by the learner, and it is necessary that the learner apply all the abstract facts from class to a real-world challenge. So performance-based assessment is here to help us in assessing students' ongoing manner, giving them feedback about how well they are learning or doing and what requires more work to achieve an ideal and perfect performance.
Did you learn something from us? We hope so. Just always remember what Donald Clifton said, yeah? Our definition of weakness is anything that gets in the way of excellent performance. I am Vanessa Josie Dodd, and I am Anna Michelle A. Magbanua, your mentor for this day. Thank you for watching!